welcome to NRG Studios. We're in Studio A, tracking a double jazz quartet. My name is Matt Brownlie.
My name is Daren Burns, and this is my session.
Yeah, it's his session.
What I'm recording is a double quartet. So we have two drum sets, two basses, and then the quartet finished off with guitar for one, piano for the other, and then two woodwind players. And then we'll also have some Indian percussion coming later on that will also, so it'll kind of divide the quartet in a way.
Yeah. So it's an interesting setup, especially for a studio like NRG, which is more set up for rock bands. We have the two drum kits has been interesting, but you know, let's walk in there and I'll try to explain my thinking on this. We don't have to worry too much about isolation with the drum kits. So we're just putting them both in the same room here. You can see we have, you know, a left side kit and a right side kit, and they're going to be kind of playing off of each other, and it's okay for all that to bleed together. Quick rundown of the drums. We have a D112 in there underneath this packing blanket, which just kind of helps keep some of the cymbals out of there. We have like 57s on the snare and the two toms. U67, two microphones up here for the overheads, 451 for the hi-hat, 452 for the ride, 441 underneath for the snare bottom, which is flipped out of phase to keep it all coherent. And that's pretty much it. And the other kit is exactly the same, except it has C12s for overheads. And then we have these DI stations. We have a guitar set up here. He's going to an amp. We actually have no DI for him. This is the guitar amp ISO room. We have the guitar player's amp in here, mic'd up, a very standard, you know, SM57 and a Royer 121. So the gain's turned up pretty loud, and then we have the volume attenuating the signal so it's not too loud. There is quite a bit of bleed, but we're letting it fly for this session. Daren is over here. He's the band leader, and his bass setup is in this area, strictly DI. And then over to the right, we have the other bass player station. So they're all going straight to Pro Tools. We don't have to worry about them having drums in their situation. For the bass DIs, we have the Avalon U5s, and I believe they're Class A DIs, which are different. And they're both the same, and those are just what they have here at NRG. And then we have the room mics here, two M49s. They're used on Deca trees all the time. So this is kind of like a pseudo Deca tree setup, and the capsules are facing the end boundaries of the drum kits. We're going to try to exaggerate the stereo image of the drums in the room. And then we have this SF24 lent to us by Royer. Just kind of throwing it up there. I'm not sure if I'm going to use it, but sometimes you just, you know, put a couple things up and take a listen in post and see if it's usable. Back here, we have the piano and electronic effects. Really super standard U67s on the piano, and it sounds really nice. Motoko Honda brought a Nord and a Chaos Pad and some other things, and she's basically taking the live feed through these mics that she brought, these black ones down here. Those are being fed into her gear, and then she's manipulating everything and sending it out to us. So four outputs total for this room. So now we have the percussion room. This is all tabla right now, and he has some other instruments, which he may or may not use. Basically using 122s lent to us by Royer for the overheads, and then these SF2 spot mics, which I don't think I've used before. So they sound really good, really full. A lot of low end, and the highs are just perfect. So, and then after that, we're going to go into the woodwind isolation rooms. Okay, so this area is the woodwind 2 isolation booth, and we got some extra packing blankets here and some gobos because it's a little live in here. So these are 122Vs that were lent to us by Royer. It's a couple of 14 mics they give us for the session. John over there really came through for us. So I usually use two of these for a large woodwind or brass instrument. This is going to be bass clarinet, and I do one at the top and to catch the upper register, one at the bottom to catch all the low subby stuff, and it seems to be working out that way. So bass clarinet miking. I'm doing this in case people walk in and knock the mics over. It's a little sandbag. These are the 122Vs, so they're tube mics, and they're also ribbon mics that Royer makes, and they one of my favorites, especially on any kind of horn instrument. piano, vibraphone, you can like anything really. Now, this is one of our woodwind stations. We have this in the control room because we don't have enough isolation for everybody. So, you know, put a couple gobos up and, you know, it's not amazing isolation for me. So I'm using headphones over here. The console's muted while we're tracking. And then between takes, I check everything and make sure the playback is okay and there's nothing crazy happening. So we have this KM84 for the flute. So when he's standing and playing flute, that's what that's for. Then we have a 122V and a 122V down there. So when he's playing bass clarinet, we have this mic for the upper register, this for the lower register of the bass clarinet instrument to capture the full range. Just want to explain the board setup really quick. There's not much to it. I'm basically just using the preamps. I'm doing probably a little bit of EQ on the first drum kit's kick drum, and that's it, just because there was a little bit of a mid-range issue. For the most part, it's just straight in, straight out, into Pro Tools, and this is all the signal being sent to Pro Tools, so I can, like, in a pinch, you know, bring down something without, you know, clicking one of the gain knobs up there, which helps. And the only outboard gear is we have the Royer 121 for the guitar amp, being preamped by this 1073, just to keep it, you know, this is phantom power is always on this console, so this protects it from being zapped.
One, two, three, four.